What's up, everybody? Welcome to Money Management Channel. My name is Andrei, and today I'm going to be doing an update on BABA ticker. And in today's video, first of all, I will show you where we are on the price chart and how we get there. Then I will continue with the fundamental news that might affect the price of this company. And at the end of this video, I will share my thoughts and my technical analysis. And I will show you what should you expect from the price action. So let's start with the price chart. I made my previous video right here, somewhere at this point, and I've told you that we might hit lower price targets. We might land at the ranges of 0.382, 0.5, and even then the golden pocket at the range of 0.618 to 0.65 Fibonacci retracement levels. And as you can see right here, we had very good support that was a resistance previously, and we hovered for quite some time around these levels. Then we broke it to the downside and we broke even 0.382 level and found another support right here at the bottom of the fourth wave. Let me show it to you. As you can see right here, we have very good support line, and we still have a possibility to move even lower. And right here on November the 4th, basically tomorrow, we will see their earnings report. And this earnings report might be a catalyst, so we have to be prepared for this. And more detailed technical analysis I will show you in several minutes, but for now let's continue with their fundamentals. So, for those of you who don't know, Alibaba Group Holding Limited, through its subsidiaries, provides technology infrastructure and marketing reach to merchants, brands, retailers and other businesses to engage with their users and customers in the People's Republic of China and internationally. And I don't want to dive deep into their financials because they are still very strong, and basically in a matter of couple of days we will see their new earnings report, and it will show us what is the sentiment, financial sentiment of this company at this very moment. So let's continue with the latest news that drives the price of this company. We are on Seeking Alpha, and this article was published on October 29th, and it's titled "Alibaba may be getting back on track after tough year on Wall Street." And let me quote you these bullets. Investors in the Chinese e-commerce leader are hoping so after a year in which the company has seen its market value cut in half by some $400 billion, as it has dealt with pressure from the government in Beijing and postponed plans to take Ant Group, Alibaba's digital payments company, public. According to a report from the Wall Street Journal, recent developments with Alibaba may help stabilize investors' sentiment about the company over the end of 2021 and into next year. The journal points to factors such as Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway, Charlie Munger investing in Alibaba via publishing company he owns, and recent appearances by Alibaba co-founder Jack Ma in Europe that suggest that he is under less scrutiny at home from Chinese government officials, as signs that the company might be able to recoup some of its losses over the past year. And I have to say that eventually this should happen, because everything that falling down should go up, and everything that goes up should fall down. And the conclusion of this article is this bullet. The journal noted that as of Friday morning, Alibaba shares had gained 15% this month. However, the company's shares were down almost 4% in the afternoon trading, as Alibaba and other Chinese internet companies lost ground following comments from Citigroup chief executive Jane Fraser about the current state of Chinese economy. And here is this article. It was published on October 29th, and I will put the link on this article in the description below. And this article was the reason of this sell-off right here. As you can see, on October 29th, we have about, let me show it to you, about 3.9% to the downside. And we broke this previous support and hit another one. Then we had this bounce, and again on November the 2nd, we have this movement to the downside. And what was the reason of this movement? Let me show you right here. On November the 2nd, we can see this article that Baidu shares fall 4% as the company plans for extraordinary shareholders meeting. And here is the bullets about this extraordinary meeting. And everybody knows that if a company tries to make this type of meeting, potentially something might go wrong. And that's why a lot of doubts push the price of Chinese companies down. And also, Along with Baidu, other Chinese internet and tech companies retreated Tuesday. Alibaba was down by 3.7%, Weibo fell almost 3%, Tencent and other also fell down. And this was the reason for this sell-off. So, we hit again this support line, and I have to say that from this point we might have a very good bounce, because it is a double bottom pattern right here, and also it is a confluence with this bottom. On top of that, let me show you this news. Alibaba changes priorities during 2021 Singles Day, albeit with exceptions. And this article was published on November the 1st, and let me quote you this. Alibaba Group Holdings Limited annual Singles Day shopping spree is set for its most sober tone ever in 2021, amid Chinese regulatory scrutiny drive on the giant company's Reuters reports. Alibaba preaches sustainability and inclusiveness rather than hyping the usual sales boom amid calls by Beijing to promote common prosperity. On top of that, Alibaba would develop new products with lower carbon footprints and pledged to make charitable donations alongside some purchases. And Singles Day, the 11th of November, is a powerful and influential platform that we will fully leverage to advocate and drive our ESG, environmental, social and governance initiatives this year. So, this company is prepared for this event. So, and let's continue with the technical analysis. But before we dive deep right here, please subscribe to my channel, hit notification bell and hit the like button. This helps me a lot. So guys, as I already mentioned, everything is very bullish on Baba ticker, because from this bottom we have completed all five ways structure, and I've told you at this moment and right here that we have to go lower in order to unload this structure, in order to have more steam to break this previous swing high and to establish new higher highs and higher lows. And this movement to the downside was 100% expectable, and that's why you can rely on my analysis as a part of your due diligence. So let me show you other signs that we are bullish. Right here, as you can see, we broke with this movement to the upside, we broke this previous resistance. This means technically we already established higher highs from the end of August, and it is also a very good sign. So, and what should you do if you want to enter the position? Basically, nothing is changed. You can accumulate your position on every movement to the downside with this price action, and our lowest, potential lowest and the best accumulation point might be right here. But there is no guarantee that we will hit it. That's why you have to ladder your buys down according to this price action. So, I think from the technical standpoint, that's it for now. I have nothing to add to this analysis. Everything is going 100% predictable, and we have to wait, patiently wait, until we will see the results of this earnings report. And right after that, I think it will be a very good catalyst for the price, and potentially we might see higher highs with next movement to the upside. So, if you like my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel with notification bell. And see you guys and girls next time. Bye!